Hey everybody, it's Invictus, and a continued Chromie Week here on the channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at a game that is going to be played on Black Hearts Bay. Ah, I tricked you. Thought I was going to go to Almost Heroes there for a second, didn't you? Yeah, no, I'm actually playing. I've been experimenting somewhat with Chromie, and I found a build that I think you all will really, really like. It is kind of a two-part hybrid build that's not quite Sandblast, but also not quite Dragon's Breath. Introduce teams real quick today. Spawning for our team is going to be Anubarak, Thrall, Chromie, Tassadar, and Li Ming, who's apparently muted, and going up against Zagara, Sonya, Brightwing, Arthas, and Nova. So this build, as I have dubbed the long-reaching sand build, or the long-reach the sand, what did I call it? I have to look at the title again. It's something to that nature. Anyway, this will focus on getting a little bit more of an emphasis on Sandblast, Chromie's Q ability, while still having the shutdown in combo potential of the W, which is Dragon's Breath. So level one, I'm going to be going for Compounding Aether. This is going to be the quest talent that will increase the amount of damage permanently by 100 after I'm able to finish hitting the quest, which is going to be 25 heroes total. Now, one thing I will say about Chromie after, I've only honestly played Chromie, like, I think two or three games total. But one thing I will say about her is that I really, really, really like how she plays. I think that she is in a very, very strong point as far as not only how much damage that she does, but also the potential of the assassination. She is kind of like, in a weird way, she's a little bit like Li Ming in the fact that she has very, very, very high long range damage potential, but she also has the ability to not have to worry about getting, you don't have to worry about too much about getting too close to your enemies, just because of how much range she does have. And of course, the amount of damage that she can burst is tremendous, and I love that about Chromie. By the way, I did find out that, yes, the time traps are indeed very similar to the toxic nests that Abathur has. So after they have spawned, they will no longer be able to be targetable, unless by AoE, I believe. So you see here, what I'm trying to do right now is basically, I need to hit 25 hero. I need to hit Sandblast on 25 targets total, which is easier said than done, of course. See if I can get a counter. There we go. I was able to hit that. So you can see down in the bottom left-hand corner, the Compounding Aether talent. I mean, I've only hit three right now. That's okay. What I try to do is double the amount of heroes hit for the amount of times that time has elapsed, I should say. Almost got the Sandblast there, actually, on Sonya. I did get a shield there by Nova, and I was able to counteract it by a Sandblast, so we are able to get first blood. Nova thought she had me. Nice shield there by Tassadar. Level three, I should say. I'm going to be going for Enveloping Assault. This is part of the two-parter, somewhat semi-hybrid build of Dragon's Breath and as well as a Sandblast. Now, the reason why I say this is kind of a hybrid is because I am going to be taking a couple. Dragon's Breath talents, but they're not going to be as prominent as me doing the Sandblast talents. And you'll be seeing the reason for that a little bit later on as we keep on trying to get the stacks of the Compounding Aether talent. But overall, so far, my original analyzation of Chromie is that she's very strong. I think that she is one of the better assassins in the game right now, period. I do not believe that she is as strong as Li Ming was when Li Ming first came out. And you're going to hear me making that comparison a lot. And the reason for that is because they both have very, very, very similar playstyles in the fact that they do have very high damage. They're able to attack from a long, long, long way away. And on top of that, they're also able to dish that damage out and get out fairly easy. Obviously, Li Ming has a little bit more of an advantage there with the fact that she can teleport. Of course, Chromie didn't have that. But Chromie does have the shutdown and the CC inside of the time trap, which is very, very cool. And you can use that to peel for yourself. What I like to do is I try to throw down an E somewhere behind me in the middle of the lane. So if I can get away, I will be able to get away if I need to. I know that Nova's going to be hanging around the watchtower here, so I'm not gonna really try to peek that right now. Level 6, I'm going to be going for Dragon's Eye. Dragon's Eye is going to increase the amount of damage by 25% in the center of the epicenter of the Dragon's Breath ability. And given the fact that I do have a 25% larger radius, means that it's going to be a little bit easier for me to land that without having to worry about getting too close to the enemies. Let's put it that way. I'm just gonna wait for that last creep to die, then head down here to the top treasure chest, as Tassadar is going toe-to-toe with a Brightwing here. No, she was able to get away there with the Pixie Dust. Gonna drop a trap right next to the chest here. Nice job by Tassar. Tassar player, despite disconnecting, has been playing a very, very solid game so far. So far, 2-0. Very close so far. So far. I was thinking about turning these in, but I've decided I'm gonna see if I can get a kill from afar. Although I don't know what's up with this pathing. I'm trying to get like closer over here, and Chromie keeps going over. That way, I was able to get the snipe with the sandblast there. So that's kind of what I'm talking about. I love the fact that sandblast goes through everything. And it basically cannot hit anything but heroes. It's probably one of my favorite abilities in the game right now. It is such a skill shot, but that's something I like. And if I can borrow a little bit of a habit that I learned from playing Invoker in Dota 2, is that I really, really love the potential of having like a global, or maybe not a global, but at least a very, very high skill shot, high range skill shot, like straight skill shot. Of course, I'm talking about Sunfire. From Invoker's kit, because that's the only hero I ever played in Dota 2, but that's beside the point. But you know what I'm saying, though. That's kind of a little bit of the feeling I get from Chromie, is that if you can hit... Oh, wow, they actually got the boss. Okay. I was not expecting that. Level 9, going to be going for Slowing Sands here. Of course, this is the heroic ability for Chromie. Chromie does get everything one level before everyone else. And we need to use that to our fullest extent right now. But the enemy team getting the... Getting the Grave Golem is a complete surprise to me. I didn't even realize he did that, but I guess that would make a little bit of sense considering how easily it was for us to turn in those coins. And the enemy team just going to be able to counter turn that one in as well. But we didn't lose a fort, so not too bad. I didn't like losing all the XP, as we could have taken a one-level lead on that, but not that big of a deal. I'm going to see if I can throw out a time trap inside of the bushes here. Nubarak's going to be taking the watchtower for us, which is awesome. So right now I'm sitting at 9 stacks of the compounding aether. Right now I should be at 12. I'm gonna go back up to top to just soak the XP here. We did lose the middle fort after all, and we are able to get our heroic. So we've got a little bit of a window. Oh, not anymore. I definitely meant it when I said we had a little bit of a window. Get down here as fast as possible. Anubarak did so much life leech there with the locust form. Zagara threw out the maw. Oh my god, and then Zagara just flew across the map. Okay. We have a lot of damage on our team, and yeah, I was able to hit. There we go. I still hit that one as well. So when it comes to the other heroic ability for Chromie, which is Temporal Loop, I'm not exactly sure how I'm going to be able to work that into a solo queue silliness game. I really don't think I'm going to be able to do much if I'm not in direct communication with my team. Let's put it that way. I did throw the Slowing Sands out. It's going to land on pretty much everyone there. Now I know that I can cancel it if I want, but I'm actually going to let it roll for now. Nice knock up there by Anubarak, and we're coming back in. They're all sitting on top of the Slowing Sands. I didn't even get a chance to hit the Brightwing with that. I'm still letting the sand slow everybody. There's a sandblast. Just barely missed Arthas. See if I turn this one on Zagara. She's gonna get taken out as well. And I think I've got Nova. There we go. So we are gonna be able to get the counter ace there. Kill the entire team. Easy peasy. That was a great job by our team. I'm going to actually cancel the Slowing Sand so I can go grab some mana as well. Level 12, I should say, I'm going to be going for Reaching Through Time. Increases the Sandblast and Dragon's Breath range. And this is going to be very, very important when it comes to doing this hybrid build of mine. Which is it's the Long Sands build, I think is what I ended up calling that. Whatever the thumbnail says is the one that I went with there, but this build, it has been a lot of fun. Now, this is the first time I'm playing this build against real people, and again, that is a little bit of a habit of mine that I've gone into, where I don't really want to ruin someone else's game by me experimenting, even though it's not Hero League, I know that, but still, all the same, I like to be as polite as possible whenever it comes to trying out new stuff, especially for heroes I've never played before. So I've got the Slowing Sands ready to go here if I need to, and it's going to land right on top of Zagara. I'm at 18 stacks right now on the compounding aether. And you see there, I'm able to get vision there with the Slowing Sands, even though there's nothing over there. I'm going to go ahead and cancel it now, but... Where did Nova go? I heard Nova somewhere. Oh man, that was a huge maw. There's the precision strike. Only hit Tassadar. Gonna throw out the slowing sands as well. We got a double kill there on Brightwing. Oh, almost got the kill. I can't believe that that didn't kill Sonya. I thought for sure Dragon's Breath was going to kill Sonya. Here comes Li Ming. She's going to blink in, kill Sonya, then she's going to go down. No, she's not. She got combustion or cataclysm kill, I should say. There we go. Now it comes down to Anub'arak versus Arthas. I think that's going to be a pretty easy one for Anub'arak, unless Brightwing comes out of nowhere. Just got re-energized. There you go. So, level 15 here, I'm going to be going for fast forward, long range sandblast, reduce the cooldown by one. Now, sometimes I do go for shifting sands. That is if I, the variation of this build that I've tried as well, let me go back to level 3 here, is with bronze talons. You can combo that with shifting sands because it's going to increase the ability power there. This time around, I'm going to be going for fast forward because I do have a feeling that I'm going to be able to land these somewhat regularly, maybe not as regularly as possible. And I do need to be careful around here. Oh, the chest is already gone. Okay. Let's see if they're actually here. No, they're not. I see them down there. So anyway, shifting sands with that, or fast forward, what I should say is that it reduces the cooldown by 1 second every time you hit a long range sandblast. I did drop a time trap here as well, and I also got a shield here from Tassadar, but unfortunately, I'm just going to get stunned until oblivion by Sonya. We did not have a Anub'arak here, and he looks like he's not going to be going up that way, so. Any lead that we had, even though it's 16-5, we're not really that far ahead. I also don't know where Thrall was at. But the enemy team undoubtedly turning in their coins right now, and Thrall is the only person who has a chance of stopping him here with the Sundering if he uses it. I'm going to be down for another 12 seconds, and no, they're not turning it in. Well, they only have one coin to turn in now. Maw's going to land only on Tassadar. I'm up in 3 seconds. There's the Banelings. Nice shift there by Tassadar. And he even dodged the Precision Strike as well. I'm coming back here. Stay alive, team. Well, this is not the path I want you to go, though. Chromie, come back over this way. Almost got the kill there on Brightwing. Oh, man. Almost got the kill on Nova as well. We're starting to fight this one back here. There's the turnaround. I haven't even been able to do anything, really, because they're all dead. So we end up getting another counter ace on the enemy team. And I did literally nothing there, but that's okay. I'm going to go in the middle and clean this up. I'm sitting at 21 stacks on the compounding Aether right now. I just want to take this one out real quick. Here we go. We need more than we need a Anub'arak up here, if possible. Drop down the sand trap behind us, just in case, or the time trap, I should say. Here comes Agar. I'm actually not going to use my my Dragon's Breath. I was able to catch Nova right inside of the time trap, and there we go. Nova Clone was actually the one who triggered it, but we were still able to get the Grave Golem, and now we're going to be able to start pushing right back. Got to be careful about getting jumped on by Sonya. Nice knock up there by Anub'arak. Yeah, still do have the Slowing Sands as well if we're able to get a nice little AoE here. Unfortunately, we don't have Li Ming or Thrall, so we're going to have to get back. And Sandblast landed on the nose. Unfortunately, it's not going to be quite enough to kill Zagar. Seeing at 24, there's the Sundering coming in from Thrall, and there we go, able to get it. I'm going to drop the Slowing Sands. I'm going to cancel it immediately, though. Put on a time trap as well. If that can land on Arthas, that'd be huge. There we go. Throughout the Slowing Sands to trap them right next to the Force Wall. Sandblast hit on the mark there, right on top of Sonya. Oh, man, that would have instantly killed Arthas if that landed, I think. Sandblast just barely missing. Going to come back here with the slowing sounds on everybody. Throw out the Dragon's Breath. Going to land right on top of Arthas. He's actually going to die. Save me, Arthas. Save, or not Arthas. Tassadar, save me. Tassadar's going back. I'm getting out of here as well. It's going to be another triple kill. And Team Solo Q, Mid Silliness 9, LMQ, Copenhagen Wolves, Toys R Us, Have Your Way, Toasty Quiznos, Subway, FBI, Investigation Station, up by 19 kills. And I really haven't been able to do a whole lot as far as the damage is concerned. Somehow I'm number one in siege damage, which is kind of weird for Chromie in a way. As you see there, now that I've completed the quest, I'm going to have an extra 100 damage tacked on top of the Sandblast base damage, which is quite a lot. We've got a lot of damage on this team, and honestly, our support and our tank, they've both been doing a really, really good job at keeping everyone in line here. Level 19, technically level 19, or the Storm Talent here at level 20, I'm going to be taking for past and future me, which is basically going to leave an echo. You saw me doing this in the first look video, where anytime I use Sandblast, there's going to be a copy of Chromie, and they're going to send out another Sandblast every time I use mine, and that's good for one shot. That does 50% less damage, but it's still big. If you can make a little crisscross, which I'll show you here the next time that I'm able to use it. Of course, I don't want to use it on creep because it doesn't count on creep. I wish that one thing I will say is that I wish Sandblast actually affected creep. Like even if it did 25% less damage, or I guess technically 75% less damage. I still would like to have the ability to hit creep. I think that would be pretty nice. See if I can hit Zagara here. Yeah, she knows the range. You don't want to test it with Chromie. Ooh, I barely missed that one on Brightwing as well. I'm going to sit here towards the back because I do not want to get hit by Arthas. Although it looks like there's a nice route there by Thrall. And oh, this is going to be huge. And Arthas just barely almost got away there. There's the copy of Sandblast that you see. Here comes another one. There's the Sundry coming out from Thrall. I'm going to throw down a Time Trap as well. It just got destroyed by the Precision Strike. Look at the long range siege damage by Chromie. Gets another one. There's two. The Sandblast Echo was able to get it. Can I get a third one on Nova? Oh, man. If that would have hit her, I would have definitely killed her, but we are pushing them back. And I can still hit from there. Let's see if I can hit it. Yo, Brightwing teleported. Brightwing with the blink heal barely saved it. There's the Echo, by the way. Let me show you that real quick. So if you can make a little bit of a crisscross, they actually come down to a vertex. And if you can basically land the vertex right on top of the enemy hero, you're going to basically one-shot, not one-shot them, but they won't be able to get away, let's put it that way. Which is what we were able to do there to Arthas, and Nova should have died, but Brightwing got a clutch blink heal off just in time to block it. Li Ming still crushing everyone in hero damage. But 28-6. Again, this has been a pretty dominant effort here. I hate using Dragon Breath just to clean out a creep tumor, but at the same time, I've got no way else to do it. So we're able to take down the top port. I'm going to go ahead and drop a Time Trap here inside of the smoke. I don't believe there's any way that the enemy team is going to safely be able to engage the Skull Golem here. Erdnova, and here we go again. There's the Slowing Sands on top of Arthas. Landed the Dragon's Breath as well. Echo is not going to hit this time. I might hit it on this time, though, as soon as it comes off a cooldown. Sonya came on in with a leap. I recasted the Slowing Sands. Another Dragon's Breath coming their way. And second Echo is not going to be enough. Almost got the kill on Sonya. So close. Li Ming still fighting. Sonya is finally going to go down. It's only Tassadar. We don't have Thrall here. I don't know where Thrall's going. Thrall's just going to go turn in. We really needed him there for that team fight because now the enemy team's going to have the Grave Golem here. And it's not, or the Skull Golem, rather. It's not over yet. He's only turning in 5 coins. We really needed Thrall for that fight. If Thrall was there to peel with the Sundering, I might have been able to stay alive. Yeah, there's no surprise here. Tastar baiting the Maw there from Zagara. We still have a two-level lead despite all of that, but we had the Storm Talons up on the enemy team. Just the problem was that the rest of our team was not there. And at 19 and a half minutes, enemy team's going to be able to take the Grave Golem. And this is going to be quite a difficult one to take down, level 19. And the enemy team's going to be able to get another turn in here just because we're going to be relegated to playing defense here. This game is not over yet. Golem is just two-shotting our turrets here. There we go. So we're finally able to take him out, not before losing our gate, and also losing not only the capping XP on the Skull Golem, but also losing the turn-in. And the enemy team able to take down the last of our forts. So that's the result of just one bad team fight. This one's not over. Thrall unfortunately missed the creep tumor there. Oh, we found an Arthas, actually. Nice force wall by Tassadar. Able to get the kill. That's a huge death. The enemy team losing Arthas for this next team fight. He's down for a long, long time. I got the Slowing Sands briefly on Brightwing there. Gonna cancel the cast here and throw out the time trap again inside of the smoke. Nova was taken out again. Arthas is going to be down for quite a while. I don't know if that clone actually stays there permanently. I have a feeling it probably doesn't. Yeah, for 5 seconds. There you go. I think we're just going to try to end this one here. We probably could, again, given the fact the enemy team is down by two heroes. There's a Slowing Sands. It would hit the first Sandblast on Zagara. Can we hit the second one? Oh, man. We got to be careful of Sonya jumping on in here. Nice Oracle there by our Tastar player. The worst thing we can do is bunch up for the Maw. That's exactly what the enemy team wants us to do right now. And Li Ming and I have got to use our range to our advantage there. The enemy team is going to live through that. Despite having two members down, they still end up thwarting our attack. Even with the Siege Giants, rather. And that's a little bit sad that we weren't able to get anything for that. Take down the Creep Tumor just because. Zagara falling on into the trap here. I'm going to throw out the Slowing Sands as well. Down goes Zagara. Dodge the Precision Strike. Here comes the Dragon Breath. Going to land right on top of Brightwing. There's the Sands Blast kill on Arthas. Landed it right on Sonya. She's going to get taken down. That's going to be the end of the game there. So you see how great the Slowing Sands is at zoning out the enemy team. And again, that just makes a zone that they just don't want to run into. And basically, that drew everyone on their team into the middle of the lane. And it basically led to that. I'm not going to say that I orchestrated the quintuple kill there. But nonetheless, we are going to be able to finish this one off here. As you see there, Sandblast doesn't even do damage to a building, so very good game. Anyway, try out this build. Let me know what you think of the Long Sands build. It's a lot of fun. Try it out for yourself. It's pretty strong. You probably do it better than I can. Final tells me 36-9 in a one-side mollywopping. Thank you for watching, everyone. Do appreciate the support. Check out my Patreon page, patreon.com/vindictive, if you'd like to find other ways to support myself. And of course, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!